po sa buhay ng bawat isa na naglaan ng oras upang sama-sama tayong magpuri at magpasalamat sa ating Panginoon. Tayo po lahat ay magsitayo. Handa na po ba tayo magpuri sa ating Panginoon? Isa pa po. Handa na po ba tayo magpuri sa ating Panginoon? Amen!
Halina't sama-sama purihin natin siya. Halina't sama-sama awitan natin siya. Ipalakpak ang iyong kamay, itaas at ikaw ay lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay. Halina't sama-sama purihin natin siya. Halina't sama-sama awitan natin siya. Ipalakpak ang iyong kamay, itaas at ikaw ay lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay.
Ulitin po natin, halina't sama-sama.
Halina't sama-sama purihin natin siya. Halina't sama-sama awitan natin siya. Ipalakpak ang iyong kamay, itaas at ikaw ay lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay.
Isa pa po!
Halina't sama-sama purihin natin siya. Halina't sama-sama awitan natin siya.
Ipalakpak
ang iyong kamay, itaas at ikaw ay lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay.
Ipalakpak, huwag po tayo mahiya.
Ipalakpak ang iyong kamay, itaas at ikaw ay lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay.
Ipalakpak!
Ipalakpak ang iyong kamay, itaas at ikaw ay lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay. Lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay.
Amen!
Lahat ay magsabing Diyos ay buhay. The Lord is great and mighty. The Spirit of the Lord is my victory. The Spirit of the Lord is great and mighty in me.
The Spirit of the Lord.
The Spirit of the Lord is great and mighty. The Spirit of the Lord is my victory. The Spirit of the Lord is great and mighty in me. The Lord is great and mighty. The Spirit of the Lord is my victory. The Spirit of the Lord. the Lord is great and mighty.
Banal mong Espiritu, Panginoon, ang aming kailangan sa aming buhay, Father God. At patuloy namin idinadalangin, Father God, na Ikaw ang manguna sa aming kalagitnaan, Father God. Habang Ikaw ay aming inaawitan, Father God, mangusap ka sa amin, Father God. At patuloy mong buksan ang aming mga puso at isipan, Father God, upang aming maranasan, Panginoon, ang Iyong banal na presensya sa umagang ito, Lord Jesus. Patuloy ka namin aawitan, Panginoon, at pupurihin sa umagang ito.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of love. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, You are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by Your presence, Lord. Oh, Holy Spirit, You are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by Your presence, Lord. Yes, Lord Jesus. There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of love. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone, Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, You are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Oh, Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Yes, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. We praise your name, oh Lord Jesus.
Mga kapatid, sabay-sabay po tayong lumapit sa ating Panginoon. Sabay-sabay nating ilapit ang ating mga puso at hayaan na siya ay mangusap sa atin. Sabay-sabay po tayong manalangin sa ating Panginoon.
Become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Oh, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Yes, O Lord Jesus. Maraming salamat, Panginoon. Naming nararanasan, Panginoon, sa umagang ito ang iyong banal na presensya, Father God. Patuloy na ikaw ang manguna sa aming mga puso't isipan, Father God. Kami narito, lumalapit sa iyo, Panginoon, nagpapakumbaba, Panginoon, na kami, Panginoon, ay malaya kang makausap, Panginoon, Lord Jesus. Patuloy na dinadalangin namin, Panginoon, na aming marinig, Panginoon, ang iyong mga tinig, Father God. Patuloy ka namin pupurihin, Panginoon, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord.
Noon, narito ang puso ko, lumalapit, lumuluhod sa banal mong trono. Maging dapatin mo, ikaw ay makapiling upang sa
sa puso at isip ko, ikaw ang sambahin. Panginoon, narito ang puso ko, lumalapit, lumuluhod sa banal mong trono. Maging tapatin mo, ikaw ay makapiling upang sa puso't isip ko'y ikaw ang sambahin. Kaya ngayon ang puso ko'y lumalapit, patawad ang sinasambit sa aking pag-awit. Kaya ngayon ako'y lumuluhod. Narito ang buhay ko, inalay sa'yo. Panginoon, narito ang puso ko, lumalapit, lumuluhod sa banal mong trono. Maging tapatin mo, ikaw ay makapiling upang sa puso't isip ko'y ikaw ang sambahin. Kaya ngayon ang puso ko'y lumalapit, patawad ang sinasambit sa aking pag-awit. Kaya ngayon ako'y lumuluhod. Narito ang buhay ko, inaalay sa'yo.
Minsan pa po, awitan po natin ang ating Panginoon.
Panginoon, narito ang puso ko, lumalapit, lumuluhod sa banal mong trono. Maging dapatin mo, ikaw ay makapiling upang sa puso't isip ko'y ikaw ang sambahin. Kaya ngayon ang puso ko'y lumalapit, patawad ang sinasambit sa aking pag-awit. Kaya ngayon ako'y lumuluhod. Narito ang buhay ko, inaalay. Kaya ngayon ang puso ko'y lumalapit, patawad ang sinasambit sa aking pag-awit. Kaya ngayon ako'y lumuluhod. Narito ang buhay ko, inaalay sa'yo. Narito ang buhay ko, inaalay sa'yo.
Yes, O Lord Jesus, Panginoon. Tunay nga, Lord Jesus, na narito ang aming mga buhay, Panginoon. Patuloy na iaalay sa'yo, Panginoon, Lord Jesus. Patuloy kaming lumalapit, Panginoon, lumuluhod sa iyong banal na harapan, Panginoon, na kami iyong patawarin, Lord, sa aming mga pagkukulang at pagkakasala, Father God. Patuloy niyo pong pakalinisin, Panginoon, ang aming mga puso at isipan, Panginoon, sa mga bagay na hindi kalugod-lugod sa iyo, Lord Jesus. Panginoon, patuloy kami nagpupurit at nagpapasalamat sa iyong kabutihan sa aming buhay, Lord Jesus. Sa iyong pagmamahal na hindi na ibibigay ng mundong ito, Father God. Patuloy naming inaanyayahan, Panginoon, ang iyong banal na Espiritu, Panginoon, na siyang manguna sa aming kalagitnaan, Father God. Na siyang mangusap sa amin, Panginoon. Buksan mo po ang aming mga puso't isipan, Father God, Lord. Ikaw lang ang aming pupurihin at itataas sa aming buhay, Lord Jesus. Bagamat kami nagkukulang at nagkakasala, Lord Jesus, patuloy mo kaming pinapatawad, Panginoon. Patuloy mo kaming inaakay, Panginoon, at hindi binibitawan, Lord Jesus. Patuloy mo kaming tulungan, Panginoon, anuman, Panginoon, ang aming mga pinagdaraanan, Father God. Ikaw ang magbigay ng kapayapaan sa bawat isa, Father God. Ikaw ang magbigay ng kasagutan, Panginoon, sa mga tanong na hindi namin maunawaan, Lord Jesus. Natanging sa iyo lamang, Panginoon, ang sagot, Panginoon, sa lahat ng aming mga problema, Father God. Alam namin, Panginoon, sa bawat pagsubok na ito, Panginoon, kami ay patuloy na lalapit sa iyo, Panginoon. Kami ay patuloy na magiging malakas, Panginoon, upang ikaw ay purihin at pasalamatan sa aming buhay, Lord Jesus. Ikaw lang ang aming kailangan sa aming buhay, Father God. Narito ang aming mga buhay. Gamitin mo kami, Panginoon. Gamitin mo kami para sa ikalulugod ng iyong pangalan, Lord Jesus. Maraming maraming salamat, Panginoon, sa umagang ito, Lord, na ikaw ang nagahari, Panginoon. Ikaw ang aming nararanasan, Lord Jesus. Sa iyo lang namin ibinabalik ang lahat ng pagpupuri at pagpapasalamat sa tanging pangalan ng iyong anak na si Jesus. Amen.
Magandang umaga po sa bawat isa. It is good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen po ba? Today, this month is our spiritual encounter month, and our focus is to allow Jesus to bring and do mighty good things in our lives. Our scripture memory verse, we could find it in John 16:13. Let us read together. When, however, the Spirit comes, who reveals the truth about God, He will lead you into all the truth. He will not speak on His own authority, but He will speak of what He hears and will tell you of things to come. John 16, verse 13. And we acknowledge and we congratulate the people that have been memorizing the full the scripture for this first season. I will read the names and may you get the certificate to our ushers na lang kasi wala po si Miss Deacon Diane. The people who memorized these are the list of the people who memorized the scripture memory verse for the first season. Antonio Te, Eric Pioquinto, Joker Santiago, Annabel Importado, Annalie Rosario, Aurigine Importado, Aurora Yu, Diana Sinin, Diana Yu, Gina Chan, Glidel Lacerna, Jael Chua, Nancy Chan, Shirley Cao, and Tess Te. You can get your certificate from the usher's table na lang, and I will give it to the usher's table. And also, we will have a night to remember on Saturday. June 22 at 7 to 9:30, we encourage you to prepare to join this prayer meeting and prepare our hearts in coming and experiencing the mighty work of the Holy Spirit to each and every one of us. And also, let us pray for our pastor Phoebe Lee as she joined a short ministry mission to Kyrgyzstan, sorry for the from June 5 to June 23. Most of their ministry will be among college students through summer camp. Let us also include her in our prayers, and let us stand and let us pray for ourselves. May I request you to please stand and let us pray for ourselves as we today hear from the word of God. May God continue to speak to our hearts. May the Holy Spirit continue to reveal his the Word of God in our hearts and apply it in our daily life. May we continue to pray for our needs and concern for ourselves, that God will continue to use us in this place to fulfill the mission that He has given us for us. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we worship you and we give you praise, for you are the God whose name is above all names all over the earth. Lord Jesus, I believe that you are our eternal God, the sustainer of life, and I believe that you are the Word who became human being, the source of life, full of grace and truth, who dwelt in us through the Holy Spirit. And as we come to your presence daily in our lives, we ask and pray that you continue to speak to our hearts. Reveal yourself to us, that we may bear witness of your words. May your words continue to be with us as we go through our lives every day, Lord. And may you continue to help us, that we will encounter you in our daily devotion with you, to understand, help us to understand your words, that we will be able to go deeper in our relationship with you. And we ask the Holy Spirit that you pour out the blessing of the Holy Spirit to each and every one of us, that it will pour out, that it will overflow to each and every one of us, to the surroundings that is around us. And we ask, Father God, that you will be the one who will continue to guide us and lead us to devote ourselves in fulfilling your will and doing the purpose, the true purpose of our life in this world. And we lift also our Pastor Phoebe into your hand. May she be protected in that place, that in her short mission in Kyrgyzstan, may you use her, that he will be continue to use her life to do the commission that you have commanded us to do. Then we lift our past Reverend Joseph Chua into your hand. May you continue to anoint his lips, that in every words that he will speak, it will be power, and we will live to the truth of your words through the Holy Spirit. May you continue to be with us, Lord Jesus. Pour your Holy Spirit to each and every one of us, because we need you. We want you to be in our lives. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for hearing and for answering our prayer. We give back all glory and honor to your most precious Son, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us open our books. In the Ephesians, the letter of Paul to the Galatians, chapter 5, verse 16 to 25. Chapter 5, verse 16 to 25. Let us read together. What I say is this: let the Spirit direct your lives, and you will not satisfy the desires of the human nature. For what our human nature wants is opposed to what the Spirit wants, and what the Spirit wants is opposed to what our human nature wants. These two are enemies, and this means that you cannot do what you want to do. If the Spirit leads you, then you are not subject to the law. What human nature does is quite plain. It shows itself in immoral, filthy, and indecent actions, in worship of idols and witchcraft. People become enemies and they fight. They become jealous, angry, and ambitious. They separate into parties and groups. They are envious, get drunk, have orgies, and do other things like this. I warn you now, as I have before. Those who do these things will not possess the kingdom of God. But the Spirit produces love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control. There is no law against such thing as this. And those who belong to Christ Jesus have put to death their human nature with all its passions and desires. The Spirit has given us life. He must also control our lives. We must not be proud or irritate one another or be jealous of one another. May the Lord bless the reading and the hearing of His word. We may now take our seats and let us welcome our Reverend Joseph as he shares the spirit of deliverance.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Now, we are now on our second week na tayo. Nasa second week. We are in the second week of our encounter. Okay. Spiritual encounter month. Okay. And so, our focus would be on allowing the Spirit to do something new and supernatural sa buhay natin. Okay. Now, why is it that we are always reminding? Because in this month, I believe God has something that He wants to do in our lives. Okay. He wants to change, to transform, as well as to bring us yung breakthrough natin. Okay. So, as we make ourselves available and we are need to be proactive in drawing near to the Lord so that we would experience a new work of God. Okay. Now, although this week, starting this starting Wednesday, okay, you know, I'm alone in home in charge of everything, yung mga kids namin, everything. And so, life become very, very exciting. Okay. And then very busy din. Okay. Now, in spite of this, you know, I decided one thing. Okay. In spite of this, I know that, you know, this month is a spiritual encounter, and it is important for us to take opportunity and be able to make ourselves available. Kaya nga, I set aside time. In spite of yung busyness ko, I especially set aside extended time. Okay, wherein I come before the Lord, come to worship, okay, and come to draw near to Him. And this week, after this week that I've been doing this extended time of coming to the Lord, you know, I feel something, okay, that is different. I sense a renewal that is happening in my life, okay, that has not been there for a long time. And so I've been sensing that God has been working in my life, and I believe that God is going to work also in every heart and every life. Okay. As long as we make ourselves available, we come before the Lord, God is going to do something that is new. Okay. So let us be intentional to encounter God. Ano ibig sabihin ng intentional? Huwag nating hintayin, but rather it is us who should come before God to draw near to God. Okay. So let us prepare our hearts. Not only every day we try to come before the Lord, but let us prepare our heart for a night to remember. Okay, that would be on June 22, wherein we want to experience a new work of the Holy Spirit. Now, I believe if you have been here for the last many times that we have, God has a lot of works, iba-ibang mga works niya sa buhay natin. And I believe that there is something new that He wants to do in our lives. Okay, we prepared, we come, and we make ourselves available. Okay, no, so now today we are on our series sermon, fifth na, panglima na, called Encountering the Holy Spirit. Okay, this would be our topic, Encountering the Holy Spirit or Encountering the Life-Changing Spirit. Okay, so we have shared that in the last sermon, sabi natin eh, the Spirit is a spirit of transformation where He transform yung life natin so that we will be able to enter into the kingdom of God, we would be able to see God, and we would be able to experience all that God has prepared for us. Today, I want to share with you this theme, the Holy Spirit, He is a spirit of deliverance. So, He is a spirit who deliver us. Deliver us from what? Deliver us from a lot of mga struggle natin sa buhay. Struggle natin with ourselves. Okay, now what does it mean? Okay, let me illustrate, okay, with my own experience. Starting last year, you know, something happened in our church. There are things that has been happening in our church. Okay, and because of what had happened, you know, some of those leaders, they started to deal with itong problema na to. And they came out, and so some people started to blame me for yung nangyari, even without verifying kung ano yung totoo. And so not only they blame me, they started to accuse me. And so because of all of this, I was really hurt. I was disappointed. Sabi ko, bakit ganun? And was angry in my heart na, you know, I've been in this church for the last 30 years. Okay, and without you going and verifying things, okay, bakit sasabihin mo na ako yung it is as if it is my fault and ako yung nag-umpisa. Okay. And so because of this anger and disappointment, you know, okay, after that started to there's a bitterness that arises within me. Okay. Now although every day I need to go to the church office, diba? Nag-office. So I need to go to church office, but whenever I went there, you know, I was not happy. Okay, I was very without joy, and I was always have this anger and bitterness that is inside me. Okay. And I try to avoid those people, yung mga tao na who accuses me without verifying, you know, I'm angry with them. So I tried to avoid those people as much as possible. Okay. And I was, during that time, I was even thinking of, you know, if working is here is not that joyful, okay, better alis na lang ako. Na even this kind of thinking nandito na sa utak ko na, okay, I would like to leave this church and go to other church. Okay. And by all but all of the while, all this is happening in my heart that is struggling, I know one thing na, you know, God doesn't want it. What God wants is reconciliation. What God wants is forgiveness. Now even though ganun ginawa nila, so I need to learn to forgive them. But on the other hand, may naman boses na dumadating na, okay, why do you need to forgive them? You know, without verifying kasalanan nila eh. If they want reconciliation, then they need to come first to me. Okay? So why should you go to them? And that is why, you know, for that last year hanggang recently, Lord, you know, I've been struggling in my, even I'm doing the ministry, but there's struggle inside me, knowing what I need to do, but at the same time, you know, the hurt, the anger, the resentment, the bitterness is fighting, and that is what I do. Okay, I'm always minding my own business. Okay, hindi ko sila pinapakilaalam. And even, I don't want to associate with them. So, this is what has been happening in my life. I believe all of us have experienced some of those things in it, no matter it is about yung family members natin or yung mga katrabaho natin. Okay? Or even some people that our own family, our own children. There are times that, you know, there are things that is happening, that there is that bitterness, there is that anger, resentment, that sometimes we don't want to talk with them. And we said, okay, bahala ka na sa buhay mo. And we know inside us as Christian, we know that, you know, it is not right and we need to deal with it, but we are powerless. We are always being affected by our emotion, by the desires that is in us, by everything that is happening right now. So, you know, these things, even the Apostle Paul, na-experience niya din to. In his life, he experienced itong sitwasyon na to. That is why when he wrote in Romans, okay, we could sense kung ano yung nangyayari sa buhay niya and what is happening inside him, the inner life, yung heart niya. Okay. So let's all read together yan. It would be from 15 and then 18 to 19 and verse 24. Let's all read. I do not understand what I do, for I don't do what I would like to do, but instead I do what I hate. For even though the desire to do good is in me, I am not able to do it. I don't do the good I want to do. Instead, I do the evil that I do not want to do. What an unhappy man I am. Who will rescue me from this body that is taking me to death? You know, this is what he experienced in life. He said, I do not understand what I do, for I don't do what I would like to do, but instead, I do what I hate. You know, a lot of times, we know what is right. We know na dapat gawin yun, pero hindi natin ginagawa. And in verse 18, for even though the desires to do good, there's that desire na, okay na, pwede na, tapos na. Okay, we need to move on and we need to deal with it. Even though there is the desires to do good in me, but I am not able to do it. There's not that power to do it. We are always being defeated by our emotion, yung mga negative. I don't do the good I want to do. Instead, I do the evil that I do not want to do. You know, a lot of times we do something, alam natin na ayaw natin. Alam natin na hindi pwedeng gawin, but we do it. And so, what Paul had experienced, and in conclusion is, what an unhappy man I am. You know, if we are always being affected by our emotion, if there is that negative things, yung, no matter it is anger, it is bitterness, is it hurt, whatever it is, heartbreak, you know, that is in our hearts, you know, we would be unhappy. It is hard to live yung life natin and find purpose in it. And so that is why Paul said, what an unhappy man I am. And he said it, who will rescue me from this body that is taking me to death? Who would be able to save me and rescue me from this kind of situation? Okay. Now, we thank God that as Christian, in spite of all the struggle that we have, we know that Jesus came. Through Jesus Christ, He delivered us. God, thank be to God, Paul said, who delivers me through Jesus Christ our Lord. Okay. So, it is through Jesus that we have been delivered, that we had been strengthened, and that we had been changed in a way that we would be able to face all of this. Okay. But even as Christian, okay, we have been saved, but still we struggle with it every day, isn't it? Meron pa rin mga bagong tao na dumadating, bagong pangyayari na dumadating that really that affect us is emotionally. And there we are still fighting, just like what Paul said. We know what to do, but we don't want to do it. We know what to do, but we are incapable of doing it. We don't have the strength to be able to overcome and do what is right. And we are always living in misery. Okay. So, today I want to share with you, how are we going to be able to be delivered from this kind of situation, from the struggle that we have inside us, from all the emotion, the passion that we have, how are we going to overcome them so that, you know, it will not bother us, it will not control us, but we would be able to live a life, okay, that is joyful, that is satisfying. Okay. As we look at the passage that we have read a while ago, in Galatians 5 verse 16, he said, walk by the Spirit and you will not gratify the desires of the flesh. Okay, walk. So, the Holy Spirit, He is the Spirit of deliverance. He could help us. He could deliver us. Okay. And so, in Galatians 5:16, He said, what I say is this, let the Spirit direct your lives and you will not satisfy the desires of the human nature. Okay. So, how are we going to be able to overcome yung desires of the human nature or the desires of our flesh? Okay. The things that has been waging war, the things that has been affecting us greatly. Okay. So why not let us all read together again this passage, because it is a very important passage about the Spirit of deliverance who came, who helped us deal with some issue, especially emotionally, so that we would be whole, we would be able to have joy, and we would live a life that is satisfying before the Lord. Okay, so why not let us all read together this again. Okay, in verse 16, what I say is this, let the Spirit direct your lives and you will not satisfy the desires of the human nature. For what our nature, human nature wants is to opposed to what the Spirit wants. And what the Spirit wants is opposed to what our human nature wants. These two are enemies. And this means that you cannot do what you want to do. If the Spirit leads you, then you are not subject to the law. What human nature does is quite plain. It shows itself in immoral, filthy, and indecent actions, in worship of idols, in witchcraft. People become enemies and they fight. They become jealous, angry, and ambitious. They separate into parties and groups. They are envious, get drunk, have orgies, and do other things like this. I warn you now, as I have before, those who do these things will not possess the kingdom of God. But the Spirit produces love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control. There is no law against such thing as this. And those who belong to Christ Jesus had put to death their human nature with all its passion and desires. The Spirit has given us life. He must also control our lives. Okay, may God bless the reading and the hearing of this word. Today I want to share with you, how do we experience deliverance from ourselves, from the inner self, or from our old human nature, yung new nature natin, that has always been affecting us emotionally. Okay. Now, if we look at the Bible, when Paul addressed itong problema to, the first thing he said that, what I say is this, let the Spirit direct your lives and you will not satisfy the desires of the human nature. Paul is saying that if we are directed by the Holy Spirit, okay, if the Holy Spirit direct our lives, you know, we will not satisfy, we will not carry out, we will not indulge in and allowing yung mga nature natin, desires of the nature to come out and affect us. We will not be able to, we will not listen to them nor do whatever they dictate, yung human nature natin. Okay. Now, maybe we think about, ano itong human nature that Paul is saying? What is this human nature that if we let the Spirit direct our lives, then we will not be doing it, we will not be satisfying it, we will not be allowing them to exist in our lives, and that we will be able to defeat them. What are those things? Okay, if we look at verse 19, okay, 19 said, what human nature does is quite plain. Ano itong mga action ng human nature? It shows itself in immoral, filthy, indecent actions, in worship of idols and witchcraft. People become enemies and they fight. They become jealous, angry, and ambitious. They separate into parties and groups. They are envious, get drunk, have orgies, and do other things like this. And I warn you now, as I have before, those who do these things will not possess the kingdom of God. Okay. So these are the actions of our inner self. You know, this is something that we have before we come to know the Lord Jesus. Nandun na yung buhay ng yun eh. This is the life that we have, the self or the sinful nature that we have. And so all of this, it will come naturally. And all of this, alam natin na bawal. Okay, immoral, filthy, indecent actions, worship of idols. Okay, instead of worshiping God, you know, other things become more important. Witchcraft, sometimes we involve in. Ano yung mga witchcraft? Mga palm reading, you go to mga horoscope, you do some mga mangkukulam to see your life. Those are witchcraft. Okay, we do sometimes those things because we are afraid, we want to know what is our life or what is our future. And then we become enemies and we fight. Okay, we fight, we become jealous, anger, okay, ambitious, sometimes we are doing it. And then we become groupings, mga parties, and there are a lot of, all of this are going on, and these are the things of the old life that we have, the old nature or the sinful nature in our lives. So the Bible tells us that if we walk by the Spirit, if we allow the Holy Spirit to direct us, okay, to direct our lives, then we will not satisfy the desires of the human nature. So in verse 17, sabi niya, for what our human nature wants is to oppose to what the Spirit wants, and what the Spirit wants is opposed to what our human nature wants. And these two are enemies, and this means that you cannot do what you want to do. We cannot do what we know what is right to do. Just like what Paul had experienced, the battle that is inside yung life niya. The things of this world or the human nature and what the Holy Spirit wants is always in a battle. And if we is directed by the Holy Spirit, what happened is not only that we will not carry out the desires of our flesh, but rather we will bear a fruit, okay, that would be beneficial for us. In verse 22, sabi niya, no? But the Spirit produces what? Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control. There is no law against such things as this. And so whenever we allow the Spirit of God to direct us, then all of those good things, okay, the love, the joy, the peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, self-control, it will come out of our lives. It will be present and it will be evident. And we will not be living in anger, but we will be living in love, being patient, being kind, being good. And so, this is the first thing that Paul said, we need to be directed by the Holy Spirit. Na ano ibig sabihin be directed by the Holy Spirit? If we want the Holy Spirit to direct our lives, then we need to be connected with the Holy Spirit, isn't it? We need to be connected with the Holy Spirit. So that is why, you know, for us to be able to overcome yung nature natin, the old nature, the sinful nature that is inside us, we need to always be connected with the Holy Spirit. And so this is the first thing that we need to do in order for us to experience deliverance. We need to walk in fellowship with the Holy Spirit. We need to walk in fellowship. Now, what does it mean by to walk in fellowship? We need to be connected with the Holy Spirit every day of our lives. And not only every day, consistently. You know, the more that we are connected with God, with the Holy Spirit, the more that the fruit of the Holy Spirit would bear in our lives. But the farther that we are with the Holy Spirit, the more that the nature, okay, our spirit, our sinful nature will come out. It will dictate how we should face, or how we should respond to yung surrounding natin. Okay, you know, we have a saying, di ba? Birds of the same feather, ano? Flocks together. That is a saying. Okay? And it is true. If you're always with people that is always complaining, ano magiging ugali mo? Nagiging complaining na rin. But if you are with people who are on all our patience, you will experience that you are being, ano, affected, you become more patient. This is something. This is life. And the same thing with our lives as Christian. You know, even as Christian, if we are far away from God, then we are near to our old nature. And all yung mga lumang buhay natin, lalabas yan. But the more that we are near to our new, to the Holy Spirit, then our new life, okay? So it would bear out a new lifestyle. Yung love, joy, peace, the fruit of the Spirit will be among us. And that is why it is important for us to spend time in the presence of God. Because sinasabi natin, Christian, every day, we need what? We need to have a time wherein we come before God in worship, in meditating on His Word, and in prayer. Bakit? Because every day, we face a lot of things that is happening in our lives. We face a lot of challenges. If we are not near to God, then we would be defeated. It is easy for us to respond in an old life ways or according to our sinful nature. Okay. This week, I started to take an extended time in fellowship with the Holy Spirit. You know, before that, every time that I'm alone or whatever, sometimes it would just pop up yung mga memory or mga faces of those people that I'm really angry or I'm really ano tagdan galit ako sa mga tao. So it would come out. And then when I think about pupunta na naman ako sa church, sa office, you know, I would struggle and said, bakit na naman ako pupunta doon? You know, it's as if every day it is without life, without meaning in going there. But you know, this week, as I spend my time coming to the Lord, because I know I need the Holy Spirit to help me. And so I spend my time, extended time. What I do is, I read through. Okay, I spend time reading through. I spend time LRT, okay, meditating on the Word of God. And then I spend time scripture praying, using the scripture in praying for me, praying for all that is happening in my life. And then I would sometimes read some mga books to help me. And then I would spend a lot of times praying, renouncing mga things that has been inside me. For example, yung anger, I need to deal with it. So I need to bring it before the Lord, asking God to help me, forgive me. And so I renounce, I come before God, I pray, and I claim God's promises. Every day, ginagawa ko yan. And after a week, you know, I feel something different. I feel something different. There is that lightness in me. And so when I went to church, you know, wala na yung pressure, nandun na naman yung tao. But it's as if not, these things had just passed by. And I am more satisfied and happy in my life. And this is something that has been changing me and experiencing a renewal that comes from God. Why? Because I came before the Lord. You know, even as pastor, you know, coming before God, okay, having a fellowship with the Holy Spirit is a good thing that would help us deal with yung mga human nature natin. Okay? So, all of us are not free from it. Okay, we are always struggling. And the more that we are with the Holy Spirit, the more that we spend time with God, the more that we would have the strength to overcome and to do what is right and to bear out the fruit of the Holy Spirit. May God help us. So that's the only way. If not, babalik na naman tayo. You know, you find out that as Christian, when we become a Christian, di ba, bagong Christian, we are very zealous for God. You see a lot of changes na nangyayari sa buhay mo. And then you feel very joyful, happy, and all people are your friends. And after a while, ano, babalik na naman yung iba dati. So sometimes yung mga ugali natin bumabalik. Sometimes yung mga pag-iisip natin bumabalik na naman. Why? Because it is the old nature that is in us. Hindi mawawala yan. It will always be there until when we go to heaven, okay, new heaven and new earth, doon mawawala na yung old life natin, and then we have this new life from God. But as we are living, it will always be there. And we would always struggle because we never know pagdating natin sa office, meron naman magbubwisit, di ba? And then maapektuhan na naman tayo, and then madadala naman tayo sa mga ano, yung mga old life natin, and this is where we deal with them. And then we find out that bakit ganun ang daming mga ano, okay, we have a lot of anger, a lot of anxiety, a lot of things. And why? Because it affects us. So the only thing for us to be able to overcome them is to walk in fellowship with the Holy Spirit, so that we would gain strength not to allow those old life to come out or to follow after what they are saying to us or dictating, but rather we would be able to live out a different kind of life, more joyful, peaceful, and more satisfying life. Okay, so this is the first thing, to walk in fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Okay, why not tell the person beside you, you need to walk in fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Right. Fellowship is being with God, is coming to Him, it is being connected with Him every day. Okay, so that is the only way for us to be able to be delivered from a lot of mga emotional baggage natin, okay, mga sinful nature natin that has been affecting us. Now the second thing for us to be able to experience deliverance from ourselves, from our old life, okay, is found in verse 24. Let's all read together. Okay, and those who belong to Christ Jesus had put to death their human nature with all its passions and desires. Okay, in verse 24 he said, those who belong to Christ Jesus have put to death their human nature with all its passion and desires. You know, when we become Christians, you know, our lives, okay, we, di ba, through baptism, okay, we died with Christ and we rose again in the newness of life. It is as if our life has been crucified with Christ, because God has get all of our sin and it has been crucified, yung old life natin, okay? And so, we who belong to Christ had put to death the human nature. And so, with all its passion and desire, yung passion natin, yung desires natin, we need to put it into death. Anong ibig sabihin? You know, when you died, what does it mean? You then have your own choice, isn't it? When you died, you don't have any choice. When you're alive, sabi mo, okay, namatay na ako, dapat ito yung gagawin nyo, itong gagawin nyo, itong gagawin nyo. Pero pag namatay ka na, ano na? Wala na. Ano pa magagawa mo? You cannot do anything. The only thing you do is to surrender kung ano yung gagawin ng ibang tao, yun na, isn't it? So, the Bible tell us, Paul tell us that, you know, when we become Christians, yung old life natin has been dead. Although sometimes nagre-resurrect yan. Okay. Kaya nga yung old life natin, bumabangon yan. So, what do? We need to put it to death every time. Now, how do we do it? By always learning to surrender. When you surrender, then yung will of our old life will not come out. We need to surrender to the Lord. And that's why this is the second thing that Paul said. Not only we need to have fellowship so that we gain strength, we gain life from the Holy Spirit to live out, okay, the fruit of the Spirit, but the second thing is we need to walk in surrender to the Holy Spirit. Yung passion natin, yung desires natin, we need to always subject them to the Holy Spirit, or surrender them to the Holy Spirit. Okay. You know, a lot of times, napansin ko isa, there's something. Okay. A lot of times, we also think that yung upbringing natin, we have our own personality, isn't it? Okay? And then, meron tayong mga sariling mga gawain o gali or yung gusto natin. Okay? And sometimes, we insist on this because this is something that is inside us. And we think that dapat ganun kasi ito yung pinaglakihan ko. This is how I'm being trained. This is that I need to do. My passion, my desires, yun ang nanguuna. But you know one thing we need to always understand. We are born sinner. And that's why all our passion and all our desire, it has been what? It has been affected. It has been not as pure as what we think na maganda to. Kaya there are a lot of things that we need to always, even yung passion natin or even yung desires natin, we need to what? We need to subject it under the Holy Spirit. We need to always bring to the Lord and said, Lord, okay, not my will, but your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You know, when Jesus was facing yung death, he said that he struggled a lot, but he said, not my will, but your will. This is what we call by surrender. Not what I want, not what I think. So that whenever we have some passions atin, or even we have something that is in our mind, we need to always come before the Holy Spirit and said, Lord, okay ba to? Is this what you want? Not mine, but yours. Remember there was one time when Paul went to yung missionary journey niya. Okay, he was very zealous for the Lord. He was going around. He wanted to share the gospel. And one time he had the plan to go a certain place na he wants to share yung gospel because there are a lot of people doesn't have not heard about Jesus. But then when he went there, the Bible said that the Holy Spirit hinders them from going in that place. And so that's why he changed yung course niya. He changed his course. He had this desire to go that place kasi it is good, di ba? To share the words of God in those people, it is good. But maybe it is not what God wants. And so the Spirit of God directed him. And then he learned to surrender yung will niya. In going that place, instead, pumunta siya sa ibang lugar wherein the Spirit has been leading him so that he was able to experience yung ministry niya more fruitful because of listening to the Holy Spirit. My brothers, sisters, may God help us. Anything that comes to our mind, everything that comes to our thoughts, everything that we feel that we want to do, every desire that is in us, we need to always subject it to the God. We need to come before the Lord and surrender them and ask, Lord, is this what you want? You know, I've been learning this in a lot of times. Sometimes when I see something na, ay, gusto ko yan. Kasi maganda yan. Okay, for example, last week, when I was riding on my motorbike, my cell phone was, nakakabit sa motor. Okay. And then, bigla na lang, natanggal. And so, nahulog. And then, yung casing niya, nahulog. Okay, the cell phone itself without the casings dropped on the road. And so I came back and I look, wow, sa likod, hindi gas-gas. Talagang biyak na. So, cell phone, my Samsung is glass, parang glass yun. So, biyak yun. And I said, paano yan? And I said, kailangan ko naman palitan nito. Okay, one thing I was very I was very sad, bakit ganun? And another thing I said, bakit pwede nang palitan? Okay, so bago na. But then even though if I have this kind of desire, but I would always come before the Lord and said, Lord, is it necessary? Okay, na bibili ako niyan. Because it's about money again. Okay. And so do I need to buy this? Because if I have this habit of doing this, hindi lang cellphone, maraming bagay yan isa-isa magiging pare-parehas yan And so I would always come before the Lord and said, Lord, do I need to buy a new one? And then I said, wala naman, hindi naman sira, yun lang hindi maganda, pero may casing naman yan hindi naman nakikita. So okay, it's always it still work. And so I dismiss yung idea of passion, of desires, of wanting to buy a new one. You know, a lot of times it is not between what is right or what is wrong. It is between what is good and what is better. And God knows what is better. And that is why may God help us. This is the second thing for us to be able to be delivered from yung passion natin and desires that has been corrupted because of our sin. And that is to surrender them to the Lord. There is a author, I don't know if you know this person, Stormy O'Martian. Okay, he was a very popular speaker, an award-winning and best-selling author and speaker. He had a lot of books, and one of the series of books that he had that is very popular is Praying. Okay, The Power of a Praying Woman, The Power of a Praying Husband, The Power of a Praying Father, The Power of a Praying, maraming ganun eh. Series yan. Okay. And so, he had written a lot of books and he is very well known. Okay. 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 Now, in one of her books titled, Lord, I Want to Be Whole. Okay. Now, she relates how she had been made whole or experienced deliverance from yung sinful nature or yung old nature niya. Okay. Now, in her growing up, she was raised by an abusive mother. Okay, that is always abusive, very abusive and verbal abusive. Now, of course, why is yung mother niya abusive and mentally may problema? Because yung mother niya, as she grow up, okay, yung mother niya, okay, also he had experienced a lot of mga difficulties. When her mother was 11, yung mother niya or yung lola ni Stormy died, okay, 11 years. And so she grew up alone in a family of uncle, and that yung uncle niya take advantage of her. And so she suffered a lot, that is why she become bitter, and so she become very abusive, and she's disturbed mentally. Okay. And so as Stormy grew up, she would experience every abusive things that this mother would do. Okay. And so that is why in his growing up, she sought comfort. Wala siyang maigawa. So she's find comfort in occult. Okay, he joined occult. He had drugs. He tried alcohol. And he went into Eastern religions. And even unhealthy relationship just to ease yung pain niya. Okay. Now, each one of those gave her temporary relief. Okay. But eventually, it made matter more worse and worse. Until one day, she was depressed, and the way that she think yung life niya to go is to commit suicide. Wala nang hope. Okay. But, okay, thank to God, someone bring him to the church, and she came to know the Lord, and she become a Christian. Okay. And not only he become a Christian, he started to attend church, and even married one of yung members of church, okay, by the name of Michael, as they got married. Okay. But even though she's a Christian going to church, but still, she would always sometimes struggle with yung anxiety attack or depression. That whenever it strike out, you know, he would be paralyzed, hindi siya makagawa ng bagay, and she would be at her bed for 2 weeks. Okay. And then as he was struggling, the only things that come to your mind niya is what? Is suicide. And so she struggled a lot. And so one day, yung wife niya, yung husband niya, took him to a counselor in their church who know how to help her. And so when she came to this counselor by the name of Mary Ann, and then she told Mary Ann, yung counselor, about yung buhay niya, how she had been abused, okay, in growing up, and that's why he had this depression, he had this suicidal thinking and a lot of things. Okay. And so after hearing all of this, okay, the counselor said, okay, I need you to do one thing. Okay. Okay, you go home and after 3 weeks, balik ka sa akin. And so within these 3 weeks, you do one thing. You went home, you take a piece of paper, and then you ask God to show you everything yung ginawa mo. Everything that you have done, the sin that you have committed, you list them down. And after you list them down, one by one, you come before the Lord and you confess it. And he said, huh? Baka 3 weeks, hindi kulang pa yan. So she went home and then she obeyed, okay, surrendered, and then one by one, okay, all that she had done, okay, he started to list them down. And after that, one by one, he commit to the Lord, he surrendered them, and he asked God for forgiveness. Okay. And after that, 3 weeks, she went back to yung counselor. And so when she went back, the counselor said, another thing that you need to do is you need to forgive your mother. And the time that he heard this, bigla na naman nagalit siya. There's that anger and bitterness, resentment that started just by thinking of yung mother niya. All of those old things that he had been experiencing all come out. But the counselor said, without forgiveness, you know, you will not be able to overcome them. And he said, I cannot forgive for all that he had done. I don't feel like forgiving. But the counselor said, you know, forgiveness is not about what you feel. Even if you don't feel like forgiving, but it is something that you need to obey, surrender to God, because this is what God wants. And so you just do it. Even if you don't feel it, you just come before the Lord and said, Lord, I want to forgive my mother for all that he had done. And then you list down kung ano yung ginawa, and then you pray to the Lord and ask God to help you, and then you choose to forgive. And then she did it. Okay. And after she did it, she experienced something that is different. She experienced something that is more light. But then, yung abusive na nangyayari, tuloy-tuloy pa rin because she had to go back to yung bahay nila. And then, again, she would be abused by yung verbally by yung mother niya. Every time that's happened, he would come back again. He would ask the Lord to forgive. He would forgive yung, in prayer, forgive yung mother niya naman. And so this had been doing it for many, many weeks na nangyari. And so one time when she was praying to the Lord and said, Lord, help me, give me the strength to forgive my mother. Suddenly, the Holy Spirit gave him some prompting. The Holy Spirit told him, why not instead of asking the Lord to give you strength to forgive, why not ask the Lord to give you the heart of the Father, how the Father looked at your mother? And immediately, she felt, and then he prayed to the Lord. He said, Lord, help me to have a heart like yours for my mother. And so as she prayed this, okay, in obedience and then in submission to the Lord, okay, to the Holy Spirit, suddenly he saw a vision. Nakita niya. And he saw a vision that he had never seen. He saw his mom that is very beautiful, that is sitting in there, and that her mom was very fun, very loving and gifted woman. Now, she never saw in her life, but she saw yung itong maganda na feature of yung mother niya. Okay. And as she was seeing her mother that way, God told her, God said that you are looking at your mother as I have planned her to be. Not what she becomes right now, but what I want her to become. But of course, there are a lot of things that happen that she becomes bitter. But my plan for her, my heart and desire for her is to be beautiful, to be fun, to be loving, to be gifted, and that he would be able to really enjoy yung life niya. Okay. And so this gave si Stormy some idea that as he saw this picture, this vision, instead of being anger, resentment, or bitter, she started to feel a compassion and sympathy for her mother. And even some love for mother, not, you know, her mother should not be like this. Okay, this is not what God wants, but because of what had happened, ganun nangyari. And so there's that pity, there's that compassion, sympathy that has been given. Okay. After a few years, her mother died. But even though her mother died, Stormy absolutely had no hard feeling toward her, no bitterness. But whenever she thought about yung mother niya, miraculously, what comes to her mind are those good moments that she had experienced with his mother in the past. And yung mga bad experience, wala na. Hindi na dumating, but only the good that is coming. And so, he experienced a release from all of this because he learned to surrender to the Lord. My brothers and sisters, you know, it's no use fighting. Okay, we fight with God, nothing is going to happen. But if we learn to surrender, there we will be able to experience the work of God in our lives. He brings joy. He brings out the gift of the Spirit of God and bringing us a life, okay, that is really abundant. And so this is the second thing that we need to do. We need what? We need to walk in surrendered to the Lord. By surrendering some of the things that we struggle with, some of the things that we hold on dearly, knowing that hindi yung ang gusto ng Diyos. Yes, we don't have the power to overcome, but we could surrender them to the Lord and allow the Spirit of God to change us, to give us the power to overcome. Okay. Now, the third thing that we need to do in order for us to experience deliverance, okay, is in verse 25. Let's all read together. The Spirit has given us life. He must also control our lives. Okay. So, the Spirit has given us life. He must also control our lives. Okay. So, not only we need to surrender, but we need what? We need to let God, the Holy Spirit, control yung life natin. We need to let the Holy Spirit control the way we should do, we should act, we should say, or we should think. Okay? It is only when God is in control, the Holy Spirit is in control, that all the old life that we have will not come out. But rather, it will be according to what God desires, or the fruit of the Spirit would be bare in our lives. Okay? Another translation is, it says that to keep in step with the Spirit. Ano ibig sabihin nun, to keep in step? It is as if two men are walking, a father and a child. Okay. And then they are walking in a road that is covered by snow. Okay. And so, you know, snow, hindi mo alam kung saan ka tatapak, di ba? So the father would make the first step and the son will step on the step of the father. And he would just follow sa behind. Wherever the father would step, there he would step. He would follow after that step. Okay. In other words, it is obeying wherever the Holy Spirit is leading us. Not only we need to surrender whatever is in our side, we need to obey wherever God, the Spirit of God, has been prompting us or has been working in our lives. When He said something, then we need to listen and we need to obey Him. So the third thing is that we need to walk in obedience to the Holy Spirit. Not only we need to have fellowship, not only that we need to surrender yung desire and passion natin, but at the same time, we need to learn obedience, to walk in obedience. Whenever God said something, then we obey. And if we obey, then something good is going to happen. And we would be able to be free from all those sinful nature that has been struggling, that has been fighting against us, and we would be able to overcome them. Okay. There was a man by the name of Rafael Arasha of Miami. Okay. Now, Rafael spent 5 years suffering from a fight he had with his 5 cousins. So they had something that they had fight, and so for 5 years he suffered. Okay, and how does this how does he suffer? Now, because of this, okay, since they were working in the same business, para sila sa business, they would fight every day. Just imagine that for the last 5 years, they would always be fighting every day. Okay, and every time that he saw them, his blood would burn and his heart would race. Okay, every time nakita ng mga yung limang okay kasin niya, okay, and he would get out of his truck with a hammer in his hand while he felt that he needed it in case na okay defend himself. Why? Because yung limang kasin lagi silang magkakasama and he is only one, okay, nag-iisa siya, and so he was afraid, so he would always have something in his hand to protect him. Okay, now one day, okay, he came to know the Lord Jesus through a church, through a friend. Okay. And so he gave his life to the Lord. Okay. And from that moment on, there was change that has happened sa life niya. Okay. And 2 months after that, he started to go to church. Okay. And he was very regular in going to church. Okay. And there was one time when he was at the church, when it was time for to give the tithes and offerings. Okay. And so the pastor said this. The pastor said, leave your envelope where you are and fix the problem you have with your enemies. You need to fix your problem first before you give your tithes. Okay. Only once you do that will God receive your offerings as a fragrant offering. And what you give will become a blessing to you. And so when Raphael heard about this, okay, the word of God, okay, and then through the Holy Spirit prompting, after the service, okay, he know that what he need to do, because he remember na 5 years he is always fighting with yung cousin siya and he need to deal with it. Okay. And so after the service, he went to the house of yung cousins. They were together as always, but their mom was there. And so he went there and he explained himself and he reconciled with them. He asked them for forgiveness as well as he forgive all that they have done. Okay. And as they were doing all of this, God did something in their life that is very incredible. Okay. And so all of them started to put yung offense nila. All of them started to okay, ask for forgiveness and they settled yung account nila or yung mga away nila. So that after that, God restored their whole family. Just imagine when the whole family had been restored, you know, the business would also be restored. Before that, they were always fighting. And so God started to bless them. And they experience something that is different. Instead of just being jealous, fighting, being angry, they started to experience joy, harmony, okay, kindness, yung goodness, and they experienced the work of God in their lives and the blessing that comes from them, because they learn, they make okay a decision to follow where God is leading them. When the Spirit of God speak to them, he obeyed, and that is why God bless him. My brothers and sisters, you know, a lot of times, it only took obedience. Whenever God speaks to us through the Holy Spirit, if we choose to obey Him, no matter what it is, yes, it is hard, but God's grace is sufficient for us. We always remember that whenever we obey God, there is always blessing that is before us. We would always experience the joy and the fulfillment that God has given in our lives. And we will be able to overcome all that is inside us, the sinful nature that has been fighting against us, and we would be able to prevail. May God help us. So, how do we experience deliverance from the struggle we have with ourselves? The anger, okay, the sin that we are doing, the things that we know that is not right, but we are too weak, don't have the strength to overcome. Okay, it is through the Holy Spirit. When we walk in fellowship with the Spirit, we find strength, we find God's helping us, changing us, so that we will not gratify or carry out the desires of our sinful nature. We need to walk in surrender to the Holy Spirit. Maybe there are things that we need to surrender to God. There are things that we want, and that it becomes our God, a passion that we are pursuing, that it is the most important thing above everything, even of God. We need to surrender them, because knowing those emotion would always affect us. Okay, so when we surrender to the Holy Spirit, He takes charge and He leads us to where His plan is. Third, we need to walk in obedience to the Holy Spirit. Maybe God has been telling you something and you've been struggling, and then you are still thinking, should I do it or not? You know, whenever the Spirit speaks, when we obey, there would always be blessing that God has for us. May God help us. So why not let us close our eyes right now? Let us come before the Lord. Okay, let us respond to Him. Paul, knowing that the things that we want to do, desire to do, we don't do it, but rather the things that we don't want to do, or we think that we should not do, those are the things that we are usually doing at the end. Why? Because we don't have the strength to overcome, because we are under their control. Even as Christian, we struggle with all of this. But we thank God that through Jesus, who had died on the cross, who had given us His Spirit, so that through the Holy Spirit, we could be able to be delivered. What do we need to do? Just like what Paul said, we need to let the Holy Spirit direct us. And in directing us, we need to be in fellowship, in connecting with God, in fellowship with God. How are you spending time with the Holy Spirit? Do you spend extended time coming to Him so that you will find new perspective, new way of doing things, and that you will not give in to your old life? Maybe God is inviting you to spend time, consistent time every day in His presence. Pray to Him. Ask Him to help you, to give you the strength to overcome all obstacles. Maybe in our midst there are things that we need to surrender to the Lord. There are passion that is good, but maybe they are not of God. There are desires that we have, but maybe it is not what God wants. If we pursue those desires, if it is our human desire, then it would always lead to a lot of troubles. But if we learn to surrender and let God lead, then we would be in good hands, because God knows what's best. Why not let's bring all those things that God has been reminding us, or the passion that we have, and let's bring them before the Lord and surrender them before God. Maybe that some of us, God has been speaking to you for a long time. He has been telling you something that you need to do, but you have been setting it aside. You're not doing it. But God wants you to obey, because in obedience, that is where we would be able to overcome sin and overcome all our sinful nature. And we would be able to live out the Spirit of God, the fruit that He had given to us. And it is where we would find blessing, joy, fulfillment. The Spirit of God is working in every hearts, and we have different struggle. But why not let's take this time right now to pray and to bring them before the Lord and ask the Lord to help us be in fellowship, surrender to Him, or be obedient to His leading. Why not let's take this time right now, just pray for ourselves. Pray for some of the things that God has been telling you or revealing to you through this message this morning. Let us pray right now. Hallelujah. Brothers, sisters, why not let us all stand up as we pray. Let's pray. Father, as we come before you, Lord, we just want to thank you, Lord. Lord, you know the struggle that we have inside our hearts. Lord, there are two voices, Lord, that is always there. One telling us, Lord, what is right. One, Lord, telling us to do otherwise. And just like Paul, Lord, we struggle. And the very things that we know we should do, we are not doing it. Lord, we are miserable, Lord, knowing, Lord, that we are always being defeated. But we thank you, Lord, because you came to rescue us by giving us a new life and by giving us, Lord, the Holy Spirit who came, Lord, to deliver us. Lord, we come to you right now, Holy Spirit, as we come, Lord, knowing that it is through our fellowship with you that we find strength, Lord, renewal, and that we would be able to live out your life, Lord, and respond, Lord, to our situation. It is, Lord, as we walk in surrender to you, our passion and desire, Lord, that you will lead us, Lord, into what is in your heart, your plan. Okay, with this best, Lord, for us. And that, Lord, you want us to walk in obedience, Lord, every time that you speak to us, that we not learn how to obey you. Yes, indeed, as we come before you, Holy Spirit, may you continue, Lord, to work, Lord, in our lives, to help us, Lord, that we would experience deliverance, Lord, from our old life. My brothers and sisters, as we close our eyes, I just want to pray for some of us. I know in spite of who we are, I believe all of us, some of us have been struggling, and we suffered from a lot of mga fights, quarrels in our family. And what God wants is for us to be reconciled together. What God wants is for us to learn to forgive, to accept one another, and to live in harmony. Even in my family, there are a lot of disharmonious things that is happening between family members. And it is only when we come before God to surrender them and ask the Lord to do His work and that we obeyed Him, can we be able to experience again wholeness and as well as reconciliation. So, if in your family you have something that is going on right now, that is breaking, that is affecting your relationship, that there is disharmony, would you please raise up your hand? Let me pray for you and ask the Lord to bring something, a spirit of unity, a spirit of love, a spirit of forgiveness in you and your family members, so that you would be able to experience again a reconciliation, coming together of your relationship. Is there anyone, you raise up your hand, let me pray for you. Yes, I've seen your hands. Yes, I've seen your hand. You could put them down. Yes, I've seen your hands. Anyone else? I've seen your hands. You know, God not only desires that we experience His abundant life, but this life would extend to our family as well. And yes, there are a lot of things that is happening because of our old nature, the sinful nature that has been working in our family members. And we need the Holy Spirit to once again come and work as we surrender them to the Lord and ask the Lord to bring that reconciliation. Let us all raise up our hands right now as we pray. And let us receive a spirit of reconciliation that God will be given to us, a peacemaker. Father, we come to you, Lord. We thank you and we praise you, Lord, because you are concerned, Lord, not only for our personal lives, but also with our families, Lord. You want us, Lord, to experience, Lord, a harmonious family, a loving family, Lord, a family wherein, Lord, we could be able to really, okay, get together, really, Lord, enjoy the company, the fellowship, Lord, and that we would be able to dissolve and then deal with, Lord, all issues, Lord, that has been happening. But we confess, Lord, that it is hard. And there are, Lord, fights. There are, Lord, mga disunity, Lord, in the family. But right now, Lord, I just want to pray for all those people that has been struggling or that have this issue, Lord. Father, right now, Lord, in Jesus' name, I pray, Holy Spirit, that you will touch them, Lord, and that give them, Lord, the spirit of reconciliation. That, Lord, there would be, Lord, peace, a life of peacemaking, Lord, that is in them. And that by your strength, Lord, they would be able, Lord, to bring peace, that they would be able, Lord, to forgive, to accept, Lord, and, Lord, to be able, Lord, to deal, Lord, and be reconciled, Lord, with family members. May you continue, Lord, to work in every families, to see, Lord, the glory that you work, Lord, in our midst. Yes, indeed, for the Spirit of God, Spirit, Lord, the fruit of the Spirit of God, Lord, is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, faithfulness, self-control, Lord. And we want all of this, Lord, to come upon our families. May, Lord, you come, Lord, and work. We thank you. We praise you, Lord. And as we stand before you, Lord, may you bless each one of us. May the grace of our Lord Jesus and the love of the Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be upon each one of us until the day that Christ will come back and bring us into his glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Okay. So why not tell the person beside you, God is going to deliver you. Okay, please be seated.
Salamat pong muli sa ating narinig. Nawa ito'y ating pong i-dalhin sa paglabas po natin dito at ito po'y ating pong bulay-bulayan sa ating pag-uwi as we continue to read our words. Na nawa patuloy nating ulitin ang mensahe na to sa ating mga quiet time para nang sa ganoon patuloy tayong mag-grow in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, that the Holy Spirit will continue to flow in us. It will overflow to the people that is around us. Amen po ba? Praise Amen. God. Let us now stand and let us sing our last song.
Oh, I love you with the love of the Lord. Yes, I love you with the love of the Lord. I can see in you the glory of my King. Yes, I love you with the love of the Lord.
God bless everyone. Have a happy weekend.